A few minutes left now before we go. We'll leave you with the six things that you should know before you head out of the door. Take you out to St. Tammany Parish first, where leaders are taking precautions, preparing for more flooding and possible power outages. Last night, several streets in St. Tammany were closed. The parish says all pumps are on and sandbags will be handed out today. To get a list of those locations, you can log on to WDSU.com or look at the bottom of your screen. A Plaquemines Parish minister has admitted to stealing more than $300,000 from people who needed FEMA trailers after Hurricane Katrina. Reverend Martin Dines was pastor of Grace Harbor Christian Ministries in Burris and the Plaquemines Parish FEMA liaison in 2007. He pleaded guilty yesterday to possessing marijuana with the intent to distribute, theft of over $500, and unauthorized use of a movable over $1,000. Dines was arrested back in January after authorities seized drugs and drug paraphernalia during a traffic stop, which led to the investigation into the FEMA program. Sentencing is set for March 24th. Closing arguments are expected today in the trial of the man accused of killing a Gentilly restaurant owner. Tyrone Wells took the stand yesterday in his own defense. He's charged with first-degree murder in the death of Jose Vasquez back in 2003. A judge declared a second mistrial in the case in March. Now to organizers for Jazz Fest announcing the lineup for 2010. The first big weekend features acts like Lionel Richie, the Allman Brothers Band, My Morning Jacket, Anita Baker, and Dr. John. There's still one more major act to be announced, and those will be performing April 23rd to 25th. And then for the second weekend, April 29th to May 2nd, are Pearl Jam, Aretha Franklin, Van Morrison, the Neville Brothers, Elvis Costello. And you can see more by logging on to our website at WDSU.com. Not such good news back here at home in terms of the traffic and the weather out there. Randy has the day off, but we are still keeping an eye out on the roads for you. And right now to the east, there's an accident approaching the twin spans at I-10 eastbound. That's at Bayou Sauvage with some heavy delays right now in that area. On the Causeway Bridge to the southbound, convoy has been lifted and speed restrictions of 45 miles per hour right now are in effect for both directions. So that's gotten a little better out there, but the northbound direction is still right lane only at this time. Keep that in mind. Now, all of your ferry boats have checked in with two boats in service at Belle Chasse. The rest are with car and pedestrian carriers, excluding the Gretna Ferry that has just checked in, though it is pedestrian only. A heads up for parents. Meantime, all public and Catholic schools in St. Charles Parish are closed today. That's St. Charles Parish. In addition to that, Norbert Relu Elementary School in Jefferson Parish is closed as well. Now, Jay has got all the important information in terms of the weather, but he wants to know what to expect.
Well, more rain. Keep the umbrella handy. Leave enough time as you head out the door wherever you're going. Let's go to our exact 3D. We'll show you some of that rainfall as it moves in, and some of it's heavy. You can see the tall extent of the reds. That's the heavier rainfall. Do want to tell you about a flash flood warning. We've got a flash flood warning up till 8:45. That is for north central Lafourche, west central St. Charles Parish, southwestern St. John, and north central Terrebonne Parish, as well as northwestern Jefferson. We are anticipating some more heavy rainfall to move through those areas. Yet again, we're getting heavy rainfall, these strong lines of thunderstorms moving through these areas. So again, that flash flood warning stays up until 8:45.
And some problems in West Wego this morning.
Yeah, there was some power lines that came down, so we'll see what that was about as well.
Yeah, the parts of the West Wego Expressway, Dino Bonanno said, are closed around Victory
right.
Drive. One last thing for you as you make your way out this morning. You will get your first chance to see the candidates for mayor face off tonight in New Orleans. WDSU has partnered with 10 local nonprofit groups to hear from the men and women who want to be the next mayor. So it's a big night for us
and
for the city of New Orleans. And WDSU news anchor Norman Robinson, by the way, will moderate that debate from Xavier University. That's coming up live on WDSU News at 6 o'clock. Of course, an important time for our city, so you'll want to tune in for that. That's it for us now. Don't forget, you can always get the latest on weather on our website at WDSU.com.